I think Kafka is the new database monolith. So a monolithic data model is a huge and complex data model usually implemented in a huge database schema. If you have such a monolithic data model and a lot of microservices or modules that use it, then you do have a problem. And the problem is the tight coupling. If one of those microservices or modules makes any change to that data model, then that will influence the other modules and microservices too, and therefore it will be hard to change anything in such a system. Actually, that's the number one problem that I see in a lot of clients. A huge and complex data model that makes it hard to change any application or any microservice that uses that model. So we could create a set of microservices that talk to one another. Each of them would have its own separate data model and its own separate database schema. And that is also what domain-driven design says. Domain-driven design says you should have separate bounded context with separate data models. That looks like a lot of chaos. So why don't we use a centralized system for the microservices to talk to one another? And that is where Kafka comes in, because Kafka is very scalable and Kafka can actually store all the information, well, forever. And we could have events like a new order comes in. And such events could be stored in Kafka and each microservice could react to it. So one microservice could create an invoice, another one could start the delivery. Oh, and we can use those events for the microservices to recreate its state. So we could throw away the state, we could come up with a new database schema, reread the information from the events, and recreate the database, for example, in a new schema. That's what's called event sourcing. But essentially, now the local databases of the microservices are just a cache. If we throw away those databases, we can recreate them from the events stored in Kafka. So essentially, we have a monolithic database model again, but this time it's in Kafka. So where did it all go wrong? First of all, when we change the communication from interfaces that two microservices have to events that are consumed by a lot of microservices, it means that we have a dependency problem because those events are processed by a lot of microservices. So there might be a lot of dependencies and it's probably hard to change those events and those data structures. Also, event sourcing as it is implemented here provides little benefits. Okay, so you can change the local database schema freely, but on the other hand, you have to create your system in a way that it can recreate its state from potentially very old events. That's hard to do correctly. And also it introduces the dependency problem that we've just seen, where you have essentially one big, huge monolithic data model. Actually, event sourcing can be used differently. So if you have an account, you can store the balance of the account or the transactions and then calculate the balance on the fly. If you store the transactions, then that's event sourcing. But that's a decision that a microservice should make. It's about how the microservice stores its own data. And that information, how the data is stored, should not be exposed. That's information hiding. Kafka as a technology is a different subject. If you use Kafka with private data models that just two microservices use to talk to one another, that's perfectly fine. It's just that Kafka often leads to the architecture that I was talking about here, and I think that's often a problem. So, thanks for listening.